The market vendors have decried the tough economic situation ahead as most of their goods perished and their stalls were burnt. Some of the traders urged government to look into their plight and support them to re-establish their businesses. They say they have to settle loans and take back their children to school. I was left with nothing. All my merchandise was destroyed in the fire. Most of my goods were lost in the fire. I lost watermelons, onions, and my money was burnt. Some of the residents who tried to stop the fire, including the area chairperson, Faizo Sebaduka, explain what transpired. What happened here is very unfortunate. When I arrived, we tried to put out the fire, but also thieves were looting people's property. Other leaders also visited the market and they sympathized with the vendors. This market is a source of income to very many people. Many people get what to eat, and also others are able to pay school fees for their children. We are not certain of what happened here, but it's very sad that the traders have lost a lot of property. The town clerk, Omar Utaro, and other leaders in the meeting vowed to support the vendors in rebuilding. We are going to try our level best to help the traders who lost their property, but we also urge traders to always pay their taxes so that we can help them during this kind of situation. Police have confirmed the incident and asked traders to be calm as investigations into the matter commence.
Abantu abasukka mu kinana be bafiiriddwa ebintu byabwe muliro ogukutte ekire kikezezo olunaku olwaleero.
Over 80 people lost their goods in the fire. It is alleged that one of the restaurant owners left a charcoal stove on. However, the fire brigade was able to put out the fire and there were no confirmed cases of death or injuries. However, investigations are still ongoing. Report compiled by Yudaya Namialo for the news.